So, My Hero Academia has a lot of interesting characters, right? But not all of them are in the My Hero 1 Justice series. So, I wanted to talk about how some of these characters could work in the game, and hopefully shine some light on them so they one day will be in the game. So, today we're going to be talking about Hontacero, because I feel like he was robbed of being in this game, and I wanted to try to help this character so one day, maybe he will be a character either in the next My Hero game, or if they ever release a Season 2 DLC pass, who knows. But I just wanted to try to help shine some light on this character because I really feel like he would be a really fun and unique character in this game. But before we begin this video, I just wanted to make this quick disclaimer that there will be some spoilers from the My Hero Academia manga and the My Hero Academia movie, My Hero Academia Heroes Rising. So I just wanted to make that quick disclaimer real quick, just in case you didn't want to get spoiled. So, you know, if you don't like spoilers, you can click off the video. That's completely understandable. And, yeah. Also, before we begin, I just wanted to quickly say that I'm trying to hit 50 subs by the end of the year, and if you guys do enjoy this video, please like and subscribe because that would really help me out, and yeah, so let's get into this video. So in My Hero Academia, Hontacero's quirk is called Tape, and although we don't get to see a lot of him in the series, kinda wish we did, we can still try to create a moveset around what we've seen, and we've still seen a fair amount of him, you know, not as much as some other characters, but we've seen enough where, you know, he's pretty much just like Spider-Man, except instead of using web slingers, he uses his tape from his elbows, so I'm pretty sure we can create a good enough moveset for him. So, in the My Hero 1 Justice series, every character pretty much has their normal attack, they have a red attack or an unblockable, they have an armor attack or a yellow attack, and then they usually have a quirk 1, a side quirk 1, a quirk 2, a side quirk 2, a plus ultra 1, a plus ultra 2, and a plus ultra level 3. But for this video, we're not going to talk about the normal attack or like the plus ultra level 3 just because the normal attack is usually just the kind of same thing for each character. They usually just do the same type of like punch or the kick, you know. So the normal attacks usually are not that very different between the characters. Same thing with the level 3. The level 3 is usually just 3 level 1s, so we're not really going to talk about that either. So we're just going to talk about the interesting stuff, and yeah. So let's start off with his quirk 1, and I've kind of labeled this as Tape Shot. So what Tape Shot could do is Sero can grab an opponent and pull them in, or maybe even grab some debris around the map that, you know how like the map gets kind of damaged? Maybe we can implement something where if you're like damaged the map enough, Sero can use his tape, grab some of like the rocks and like debris around and just throw them like projectiles. I feel like that'd be an interesting way to like make the best of two things where A, you have, you know, a good move, which can be a grab, but it can also be like a projectile. But B, it also kind of implements something where, you know, stage debris has been in the My Hero 1 Justice series, I think, since the first game, and it really hasn't done anything except for look kind of cool and lag the game a bit, but, you know, other than that. But I feel like it'd be an interesting way to, like, kind of combine the two, where a character can interact with the stage debris and kind of just use them as a projectile. I think that'd be a really interesting way to, like, finally use something that kind of hinders the game a bit sometimes, because it does make the game lag because a lot of things happen, but, you know, I think that'd be an interesting way to kind of combine the two. And also, I gotta make this comment real quick because I know a lot of people are. I know a lot of people are gonna say that Sero is gonna probably play a lot like Aizawa, and being that, like, let's just say if you grab someone with the tape, it's gonna be kind of like Aizawa's scarf. And, you know, your point would be pretty valid if, how do I put this? There are 3 Dekus in the game. So I don't think uniqueness is going to be an issue, you know what I'm saying? Like, there are 3 Dekus in the game. So Sero being kind of similar to Aizawa, I don't think is going to be the biggest issue. But yeah, so I think that's going to be like a real interesting first quirk move. I think his Q1, I think that would be an interesting way to just implement it. So that's my quirk 1 for him. My side quirk 1 for him is, it's kind of like, oh gosh, I just made the comparison with Aizawa. If you hold it, it could be kind of like a red attack, and then, you know, what you could probably do is he can probably, you know, bind you up in this tape and then kind of like slam you down a bit, which would cause maybe a bounce effect, which then you can go into like a combo, like if you dash cancel maybe, or if you just dash into it, you can probably just start a nice little auto combo or something, and I think that would be a pretty unique way of doing it. It would probably be a mid-range attack. It probably wouldn't be as long as Tokoyami's, but it would still be pretty cool. So for his quirk 2, I'm gonna label it as Tape Barricade, you know, like one of his ultimate moves from the manga. And I think what Sero could do is Sero can shoot strands of tape, which can connect with the other tape that he shoots out, and, you know, kind of create kind of like a trap, kind of like Kaminari a bit, except it can probably be like, you know, vertical, it can be like horizontal, and he can shoot up to 5 of them. You know how Kaminari can only do 3 and set up a trap, maybe he can do like 5 and kind of make a, like a bigger range type of area. And maybe if he charged up the ability, he can just shoot out like some type of big trap. And what the trap could do is if you walk into it, it can kind of like cause like a stun where like the tape kind of wraps around the person like an animation. And or it could block incoming projectiles because like, you know, tape barricade, it's supposed to like protect against projectiles. So maybe he can like position it so you can like set it up as like, you know, a barricade, so if someone shoots like a projectile, it'll like break against it, or maybe destroy like some of the tape strands and stuff like that. I think that'd be an interesting way, because then you can play him in 2 different ways. You can play him as a trap character or a very defensive character, and, you know, set up like kind of like a wall of tape. And, you know, maybe then it'd be cool with tape grab, you can pull them into the tape trap. That'd be pretty cool, but I think that would be an interesting quirk too. So for a side quirk too, I've labeled it as Tape Swing, because you can't have Sarah without a Tape Swing, you know, it's just like Spider-Man, you can't just do that. So what Tape Swing can do is, it can pretty much allow him to swing with his tape. The way it could work is, Sarah could use his tape, and then you can like aim it, and, you know, depending on like where you are, like let's just say if you're in the air, and you shoot it, you can use your control stick to kind of like aim where you want to shoot the tape, shoot it out, and then he can swing to that location. And if you want to cancel it, you can probably like jump, and then you can fire another strand of tape, which would allow him to have really great mobility. And obviously there would be a limit on it, maybe like 3 to 5 uses on it, which would allow him to have mobility, but you can attack him in that animation. So yeah, that'd be pretty interesting. Also, if he's on the ground, you can probably like aim it upward, so like Sarah kind of like puts his arm up and then he kind of shoots it upward, so he can get like more of a faster type of jump. So because like in the game you can have like a double jump where like let's just say I'm Kaminari and I want to get some real height. If I want to get some real height, I would have to click like the A button twice and I would jump up twice, you know. But for Sarah, you can just, you know, press his side quirk to aim it up, and he can pretty much get that without double jumping, you know. And I feel like that'd be just an interesting way of, like, you know, an interesting way of movement, because Twice kind of does that, but not really, because at the end he kind of like slides sometimes and he has that goofy animation. This one, I feel like it would be interesting because you can control it a little more. It would probably have a lot more uses, and then, you know, you wouldn't have to be stuck with like a slide at the end or like some type of animation. It would just be, you know, unique to itself. And I feel like that's how Tape Swing could work. So now we're going to move on to his red attack and his armor attack. So his red attack, I feel like could just be kind of like a normal kind of punch. Nothing flashy, just because, you know, most of the attacks I've kind of just labeled off are kind of ranged attacks. So we would kind of want to give him some close quarter combat capabilities along with his normal target combo. So I feel like a normal red attack would kind of suit him. But for his armor attack, I've labeled it as Tape Kick, and the way it could work is Sarah could jump backwards with this tape and then kind of go into like a leaping kick, you know, kind of like a slam kick where he kind of, you know, uses the speed he built up from like, you know, jumping backwards and kind of rams into them with a really solid kick. And I think that'd be an interesting animation. I don't know if you could follow up with that, like with a combo, maybe if you dash cancel you could, like, but I don't think it would cause a bounce. Maybe it would cause like kind of like a slam, or like a ground splatter or something like that. I don't really know, but I think that would be a pretty unique, interesting kind of animation, and it would definitely be one of the more unique armor moves in the game. So now we're gonna move on to the level 1 and 2. Like I said, we're not gonna do the level 3 because the level 3 is just pretty much the level 1. So for his level 1, I'm gonna label it obviously kind of like one of his ultimate moves, Tape Shot Trident. And in My Hero Academia Heroes Rising, the way it worked is he kind of ran up against 9 and he used this tape to like hurl a bunch of rocks at 9. And I feel like that'd be an interesting move because, you know, he could have like the animation where he's like running up and then you can kind of like look into his helmet, and then behind him after he yells like Tape Shot Trident or something like that, it kind of cuts to it and there's just a bunch of tape with rocks hanging there, and he pulls the rocks down and then the rock animations start hitting you. And it would kind of be like Uraraka's, except it would come at you at like an angle and I think faster. And I think that would be a real cool unique animation, and also another way to just incorporate an ultimate move Sarah has created. So I think that'd be pretty cool. For his level 2, his level 2 is a little harder because the animations are, you know, they're really flashy. So I've kind of come up with like a little bit of an animation they could probably do, or, you know, level 2 is kind of just in the air. So for my animation, I feel like Sarah could probably tape you up, right? Like, you know, he would just tape you up with his tape and then kind of slam you around a bit. And then in the end, you know, after you're kind of like dazed and stuff like that, Sero kind of just jumps into the air and kind of goes into like one of those kicks, like in My Hero Academia Heroes Rising when he, you know, taped up Nine's arm and he went in for that kick. I feel like that'd be pretty cool, except instead of getting blown away from Nine, he, you know, lands the kick and it's kind of like this big, like, debris explosion kind of effect. And then, you know, like Sero stands up at the end of the animation. So I think that'd be just a really cool animation, and we kind of like, you know, follow up from My Hero Academia Heroes Rising, so that'd be pretty cool. So that's pretty much my moveset for Sero. Some other side things they could probably do, maybe for his assist, you know, it could kind of be like where he comes in and then shoots like a strand of tape, and instead of being like Aizawa, where Aizawa kind of wraps him up and stays there, maybe Sero can kind of like shoot the tape and it's like a projectile, so it shoots, and then if they get touched by the tape, they get in that wrapped animation. So it'd be kind of different from Aizawa's, where the fact that it's kind of like a projectile, not like this like Aizawa shooting the scarf and he stays there, it would be just like he shoots it and if you touch it, you get wrapped up. So that'd be a pretty cool assist. Some other things they could do is, you know how like in My Hero 1's Justice, like if you're playing as Ida and if you get hit so many times, the helmet kind of flies off. They could do that, or they could do it where if you get hit too many times, Sero's helmet could kind of like break instead of like, you know, getting flung off right away. Just because in My Hero Academia Heroes Rising, he had that really cool look where, you know, his visor got broken. So it was, you can see like parts of his face with the helmet still on. So maybe they could do that. Or maybe that could be a cosmetic look. That'd be pretty cool. But yeah, man, Sero would look really cool in this game. Like, you think about it. Like, even if you don't like the character's costume is sick. Like, the shoulder pads and the helmet, like, that's a really cool look. So, yeah, that is my input on how Sero could work in this game. He has a lot of different potential in this game, you know. He could be, like, one of those characters that have some really good projectiles, but you just can't spam them, you know what I'm saying? It would be, like, a very technical character. I think he'd be a very fun addition. And again, I know a lot of people were just going to compare him to Aizawa, but like, there are three Deckers in the game, so I don't think that's going to be an issue. I think the issue is just getting enough hype for him to be in the game, and that's the whole point of this little series now. I'm just trying to do this series to drum up some attention for these characters, and maybe one day they will be in the My Hero 1's Justice series, because I know a lot of people kind of wanted him. I've seen him around being in people's wish lists and stuff like that, and he was in mine too, but just sadly didn't make the cut, even though he played a prominent role in the provisional license exam arc, and that was the first half of the campaign, but you know, he's just not in the game. But yeah, so that's my Sero video. If you guys want to see any type of specific character, I can try to make a moveset for them. Obviously it's going to have to be a character that actually has some combat potential. Like, if someone comments down below Airy, I don't know what I'm going to do with that, because you know, I haven't seen Harry punch someone, so I don't know how easy of a moveset it would be to make for that character. But for other characters, I can do my best and try to make a moveset for them with this nice new little series I'm starting up. Because, you know, some of these characters really do deserve to be in this game, and they're just not. So we're trying to bring some attention for them. And I don't really know how much to put that. So yeah, that is my Sero video, and if you guys did enjoy, please like and subscribe. That would be amazing. Again, I am trying to hit 50 subs by the end of the year, so if you guys could help me out with that, that would be amazing. Like I said, if you have any characters you would like to see in this series, I will do my best to try to make a moveset for them. Just comment them below. So I hope you guys did enjoy, and I will see you guys next time. Later.